welcome you all on today's session. I am Deepika Rathod, Chief Nutrition Officer, Head Nutritionist, Lifestyle Expert and Head of Gut Vertical from Luke's team. And today we are here to talk about certain resolutions that you can follow on a daily basis in the new year to work on improving your gut health. Now, when you talk about resolutions, I've heard many people, you know, fixing certain resolutions around the new year, but within 1 or 2 weeks, it starts fading off. So resolution is something that you can stick to all the year, not just for first 2 weeks. Like I have seen people, you know, telling me that, okay, I'll join gym and do exercise on a regular basis. Okay, 1 week, 2 week, 3 week into it, maximum month into it. And after that, they all start feeling lazy, particularly in winter season, getting up early morning, going to the, gym session. It becomes very tasking for them. And that's where they stop doing it. So ideally, when you take a resolution, it becomes extremely difficult for certain people to stick to it. There are a very few handful who, take some resolution and then stick to it on a regular basis. But then ultimately, try and make certain basic changes or try and go out for certain basic resolutions to make sure that you work on your overall health, not just the gut health, but overall health to keep you healthy in that year and in coming years as well. So rather than doing certain things which are too extremes, you know, doing fat diets or doing extra gymming or, sleeping really early and waking up really early around 4 o'clock or so to, you know, do all your chores or activity and all. If these things are not really imbibed in you and it's not really manageable by you, then it's better not to take such resolutions. So today I'm here to help you with certain resolutions that you can work upon. These are very basic ones. You might have heard few of them from me, few of them from Luke, but we are here to keep reiterating these things because with our day-to-day activity, we sometimes forget about the basic things that we need to do to make sure that we are staying healthy, to make sure that we are not getting prone to any kind of infection or disease in future. So for that, let me give you maybe 4 or 5 certain basic resolutions that you can take in this month itself and continue following it on a regular basis to make sure that you are feeling better. Now, as I said, people take extreme decisions, extreme resolutions. They say that I will eat only healthy food, I will not eat outside food, junk food, processed food, moving forward. And then they do it for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, but then that craving starts kicking in. Or because they have deprived themselves from these kind of food, they end up binging on certain food, which then creates more issue in the body. So rather than, you know, sticking to this hard rule, why can't we just start following moderation? So maybe 5 or 6 days a week, try and eat only healthy home-cooked food, which you can digest properly, which will help you in improving your overall, gut-related conditions like acidity or bloating or constipation issues. And then once in a week or one meal per week can be your reward meal, wherein you're enjoying something that you like to enjoy. It could be a, healthy food. It could be a reward meal, like something from outside. It could be a junk. It could be a processed food as well. But ultimately, moderation is what we are looking at. So moderation and not deprivation. So let's make this first resolution that I am not going to go all out and start eating only and only healthy food till the time my body, just don't start craving for unhealthy food. But I'm going to stick to a moderative kind of food, wherein I follow a healthy routine for 6 days a week, and one day I can eat the reward meal, that too in moderation. Not too much, because then that too much will also affect your body. But at least your mind and your gut is at ease that, yes, I am getting balance of both the food or both the criteria. The second resolution I want you all to take is about going raw till lunch. So at least 3 days a week, try and follow a raw till lunch routine. Now, raw till lunch means you can't have anything in cooked form. Now, why raw till lunch? We have seen nowadays, due to our hectic schedule, due to bad lifestyle, due to outside food or unhealthy food, our stomach goes for a toss. we start suffering from acidity, we start suffering from bloating, we start suffering from constipation, loose motion, you name it, and you have those issues in the body. So this also suggests that our body somewhere starts depleting of the digestive enzymes. Digestive enzymes are needed by the body to digest the food that we are providing, absorb it, assimilate it properly so that our body gets enough amount of nutrients which is required for the growth and development of each and every cell or organ. So for that very reason, if you go raw till lunch at least 3 days a week, you will get all your natural digestive enzymes from the raw food. Now when I say raw food, that means you are not supposed to have raw vegetables like pumpkin, potatoes and all, but raw vegetables which you can have it in raw form. So carrots are there, cucumbers are there, you can have that in morning, you can have fruits in the morning, you can even have nuts and seeds. So always club your nuts and seeds with your fruit so that the fruit doesn't spike up the sugar levels. Have your nuts and seeds first, then you have fruit. In between you can even add like a vegetable salad or a smoothie kind of thing if you enjoy having smoothies. And your lunch can be your cooked meal, a proper cooked meal of a vegetable, then a protein and then a carb. Always try to follow the UK lifestyle flow as well. Okay, so that brings me to the third resolution, that is following the UK lifestyle flow. So when you eat in the right order, when you eat with the right intention, your body is getting good amount of nutrition. When you start your food with vegetables, that adds fiber in your body. As I said, you will get digestive enzymes plus the alkaline dose to make sure that your acidity starts coming under control. After that, you move to protein. Protein is the building block of our body. Our body requires protein for healing, repair, recovery, for building muscle as well. So try and add protein secondly, and then chew it properly. After you're done with the protein, last should be your carbs. So you are eating carbs, but at the same time your body tells you how much to eat. So this is the third resolution that I want you all to follow. We have the document up there on our website as well. Go and check it. You get lifestyle flow. You need to follow on a regular basis just to make sure that you control your portion size. You have the right kind of food at right time so that your body get all the nutrition. After that, despite of informing everyone about how important it is to chew your meal, I see most of them not doing it because they are short of time. They don't have time, they have back-to-back meetings, they have to take care of their kids, they have so much of work on the head, they can't really sit at one place and eat, because if they eat, they are losing out on time. So my fourth resolution for everyone would be to sit down, take good amount of time, chew your food properly. No matter what, you should take around 20 to 30 minutes to finish a meal. That's where the lunch breaks in offices are also for 1 hour, so that you get a good amount of time for eating your food, resting, coming back and then starting the work. So utilize those kind of time, that time, and make sure that you're chewing your food properly. If you're still not doing it, you are affecting your stomach, because what will happen is you will end up eating fast, you will end up trapping air bubbles in between the food molecule. That will increase your bloating, that will create more indigestion, that can lead to constipation, that can lead to any further issues. So try and make sure that you slow down and chew your food properly to avoid any kind of gut related issues. After that, I would want to talk about sugar. So I have seen that now it was New Year, we all celebrated it. In fact, we celebrated it from Christmas itself. So too many sweets happened, too many sugar loaded stuff, cakes, pastries and all of those things happened. And after that, I did see many people saying that now I'm not going to touch the sugar. It is good, okay, but try and add a little substitute in your routine so that you don't miss the sugar as well. It's really good to stay away from white processed sugar. So fifth resolution, if that works for y'all, try and make sure that you stay away from white processed sugar on most of the days. Because white processed sugar is acidic in nature, it feeds your bad bacteria, it can increase the chances of any kind of infection in the stomach. So try and make sure that you're staying away from these kind of artificial sweeteners, processed sugar, or things which will keep your body more acidic. This also delays the healing process or increases inflammation in the body. Apart from that, for most of the people who want their skin to look better, who want their skin to look glowing, sugar is a big no-no, because sugar starts attacking your skin cells, tissues, and it makes it look more more wrinkled, more aged. So if you want to work on anti-aging, longevity as well, try and make sure that you're giving up on the sugar, particularly the white processed sugar. It's fine to have jaggery, coconut sugar, raisins, figs, natural sugar, or fruits sugar for that matter, fructose from fruit, in moderation. Don't overdo on it as well, because overdoing on any healthy stuff will also create more stress and more issues in the body. So try and make sure that you avoid sugar. And as I said, sugar feeds the bad cells in the body. Bacteria in the body. So if the bad bacteria starts outnumbering the good bacteria, it will have a huge impact on your stomach, on your gut health, on your overall health. It can lead to more infection as well. There can be higher chances of gut dysbiosis, SIBO, and other stomach related issues. Even H. pylori is a bacteria, and sugar feeds these kind of bacteria. So try and stay away from sugar, white processed sugar, as much as possible. When I talk to you about the bad bacteria, I want you all to replenish your body with the good bacteria as well. Because we are traveling, we are we are facing pollution, we are not eating on time, our gut health goes for a toss, our stomach is not working up to the mark, or it has certain issues. Sometimes people also start losing good bacteria because of loose motion or diarrhea. So let's make sure that you add a natural probiotic in your meal or in your routine on a daily basis. Now this natural probiotic can be a curd or a buttermilk as well. A curd or a buttermilk made from A2 organic milk will be the best option. If you are allergic to lactose, if you are having any kind of autoimmune condition wherein casein is not really suggested for you because it might increase the inflammation, in that case you can change to coconut curd, you can change to almond curd, or the natural way to get probiotic is by just having rice kanji. Take 2 tablespoons of cooked rice, mix it with water, cover it and cook it in keep it in an earthen pot overnight. Next morning, first thing in the morning, what you do is chew on that rice and drink that water. And this is the best probiotic that anyone can have. And because it is just rice and water, even kids can have it. So if you're having this kind of probiotic on a daily basis, at least to start with for 15-20 days, and then do it 2-3 times a week, it will help you in replenishing your good bacteria. If your good bacteria are proper in number, it will outnumber the bad bacteria, or it will take care of the bad bacteria, destroy it from the body, and it will also prevent you from different kind of infection. Now this was about probiotic. If your body is, or the stomach is highly compromised, if you have lower number of probiotics, if your stomach shows symptoms, then you can talk to your healthcare provider as well. And maybe you might need to start on a probiotic supplement to just take care of the gut related issues. But having a probiotic, whether it is natural or through supplementation, really works in improving the good bacteria. We don't have to overdo on this as well. That's where I said, even if you're starting the natural probiotic, do it on a daily basis for 15-20 days. And then you can do it every alternate day or 2-3 times a week to get good amount of bacteria for the stomach. Now, when I talked about bacteria, my next resolution would be again to go back and add more vegetables in your routine. As I said, we'll be going raw till lunch. So raw till lunch 3 times a week is really important, but at the same time, make sure that you're adding salad, stir-fried vegetables, sauteed vegetables, something or the other in your meal on a daily basis, because the fiber from the vegetables acts as a prebiotic. Prebiotic is the food for your good bacteria. So no matter how how good your intake is of probiotic, but if you're not providing the prebiotic, that is the food for your good bacteria, your probiotics may not flourish properly in the stomach. So that's where focus on adding more vegetables in each meal. That vegetables will also add fiber, that vegetables will also add antioxidants into your meal, into your routine, and that will help you in staying away from different kind of diseases. It will also keep your gut health in check. It will help you in improving your stomach related issues like constipation, acidity, bloating, all of these things. Apart from that, the last thing or the last resolution that I want you all to take is about your exercise. Your 1 hour of gym activity is practically useless if you're sitting at one place throughout the day. Because when you're sitting at one place for a longer period, your body starts producing lactic acid. That's where the blood circulation to that particular area stops. So you might have noticed that if you're sitting for a longer duration, you tend to get those not cramps, but kind of tingling sensation in your legs or in your hips or in your thigh muscle. That's because there is lactic acid production happening over there, and the blood circulation to that particular area stops for a while. So that's why you have to make sure that move around every 45 minutes to an hour to not allow the lactic acid buildup in the body, and at the same time to improve the blood circulation. Okay, you might be going to the gym, but apart from that, if you try and increase your step counts throughout the day and track around 8,000 to 10,000 steps, that will keep you fairly active. If you can't even go to the gym, at least try and make sure that you take a resolution of doing say 20 minutes of walk daily, just 20 minutes from your routine, and that will help you in improving your blood circulation. As and when you get used to it, that 20 minutes can go up to 30 and 45 minutes as well. So try and make sure that you move around as much as possible. 30 minutes after your meal as well, try to move around so that your blood circulation improves, your digestion improves, and you feel much better with respect to digestion. So these were certain resolutions that I want you all to ponder upon, work upon, try to incorporate these things to make sure that you follow the basics to take care of your stomach health. And if your stomach health is in check, you are healthy overall, because everything starts with a bad stomach itself. So if you have bad stomach, your energy level starts dropping, your nutrient uptake in the body is reduced, you see deficiencies in the body, you're not productive enough, you're not active enough. So try and make sure that you take care of your stomach health to feel better, to feel more productive, to feel more agile, mindful, and more healthy. Let me just see if I have any questions over here. Okay. I often have heartburn, though I have not had dairy for last few days. What exactly leads to that heartburn? We have to find out that root cause. It may not be dairy. Do you think that you're not drinking enough amount of water? Does your meal have good amount of vegetables to add the digestive enzymes to take care of the acidity? Are you eating your meals on time? If you're not eating your meals on time, that can also lead to acid buildup in the body, and which can lead to heartburn. Or is there any other underlying condition that you need to check with your doctor, get it diagnosed, so that we can find out what is the cause of this heartburn? So these are certain things that you can work upon. But as I said, try and add more vegetables. If you're not comfortable with raw vegetables, it's fine. You can have stir-fried cooked vegetables as well, because that also helps in improving the overall digestion. Okay. What can I do for GERD? Now, GERD is nothing but gastroesophageal reflux disease. That means your acid is trickling up the esophagus. GERD is a condition wherein your doctor will definitely put you on certain antacids, because the esophageal sphincter is loose. So whenever you lie down or whenever you are even in inclined position, the esophagus allows the stomach acid to trickle up, and that's where the reflux creates more issue, or it affects the esophageal lining as well. So to avoid GERD or reflux to increase in a way wherein it is affecting your day-to-day activity, make sure that you don't lie down at least 2 hours after the meal. Okay, for 2 hours you need to sit upright, you need to sit in a proper position wherein your back is straight, because this will help in the digestion process to get completed, and then only after that you can lie down. So even if you are sleeping, try and make sure that the gap between your dinner and your bedtime is 3 hours, 2 to 3 hours, 3 hours to be on a safer side, because that will help you in overcoming the nocturnal GERD. So particularly when you sleep at night, because of the lying down position, the acids can come up and irritate the throat, which can affect, you know, our vocal cords, which can affect our larynx and pharynx as well, for that matter. So try and make sure that you don't lie down immediately after the meal. Keep 2 hours or maximum 3 hours gap, that should be good enough. And you can even sip on more water throughout the day, not with the meal or not immediately after the meal, but throughout the day. Try to incorporate lemon water, fennel infused water, because these things have cooling effect on the stomach. It has digestive enzymes as well. It works on controlling the acidity and keeps the body more alkaline, so the acid reflux starts getting managed properly. So that was about GERD. Okay. Can I add rolled oats? Okay. So rolled oats are the processed oats. If you want to add oats, steel cut oats or oats groat are more beneficial, because they have the nutrients intact. So you have your gehu, then you have your dalia, and then you have your atta. So oats groat is your gehu, steel cut oats is your dalia, and atta will be your rolled oats. So the groats oat will have more nutrients because it is the whole part, and it will be more healthy, nourishing to the body as well. But in case you feel that it is too hard for you to digest high fiber food like a oats groat or a steel cut oats, then yes, definitely rolled oats is completely fine. Great. Fine. Can I have dates if I'm not having white processed sugar? Okay. Yeah, so as I said, white processed sugar will feed the bad bacteria in the stomach. It keeps the body acidic. And if you have any issues related to acidity, it's better to stay away from white processed sugar. But yes, natural sweeteners like your dates, figs, raisins are completely fine. You can have that. Maybe 2 dates per day, or 2 figs or 2 prunes per day is completely fine. Don't add everything together, because too much of fructose load as well is not good for the body. So have one thing at a time, and that should be helpful enough. Okay, I think we don't have more questions here. I hope you enjoyed the session. Just make sure that whatever things we discussed today about the resolutions and all, try and incorporate at least 2-3 resolutions in your routine and see the difference. You can try and go raw till lunch for 3 days a week. It really makes you feel lighter. It provides you with digestive enzymes. It can help you in controlling your acidity as well, or acid reflux for that matter. So try and follow these tips, and you can keep us posted on how you guys are feeling. Take care. Bye.